Now we're going to try another little proof by induction example. So here's the thing that we're wanting to prove. Now, by induction, we always want to demonstrate it or show true for the base case. So I would recommend pausing the video and seeing how far you can get. And if you're like, no, that's fine here, so I don't have to work that hard. I understand. So in this case, we can tell, maybe, that in this case, our base case is actually going to be 2 because we want to go just the simplest thing possible. So for I going from 2 to 2. And I know in the previous example, if you saw that we were looking at k's and we're looking at j's and all that kind of stuff. You just have to be flexible in dealing with different kinds of letters. So in our case, the base case is n is equal to 2 because that's the smallest thing we can say. Now this pi, remember that means product. So we're going I going from 1 to 2. And again, I'm sorry my voice is all still kind of messed up because it's hard to talk when you're little, whatever you call it, thingy is broken voice. So this is going to be 2 plus 1 over 2 times n, which is again 2. Okay, so remember that the big pi is the product, just like a summation. So everywhere we see an I, I'm going to put a 2. So 1 to 2 squared. And I want to know, I should put the equals, the question mark there. Is that going to be equal to 3 over 4? So I have 1 minus 1 fourth. Is that equal to 3 fourths? And yes, 3 fourths is equal to 3 fourths denny bunnies. Okay, yay. Okay. So we've shown it's true for the base case. Now what we want to do is we want to assume it's true. No. Here we go. Assume true for k equals some k. Okay, so in our case, we're going to say, we're going to assume it's true that pi going from I equals 2 to k of 1 minus 1 over I squared is equal to k plus 1 over 2k. So that's our assumption. So as we move forward, no matter what, we're going to just kind of assume that's true. So now that we've assumed that was true, ooh, come back. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to set a goal to show it's true for k plus 1. So again, this is our goal. Our goal is going to be to show that this product from I going to 2 to now k plus 1 over 1 minus da 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 da, we want to show that that's going to be equal to k plus 1 plus 1 over 2 k plus 1. So again, everywhere here that I had an n and I replaced the n with a k, same thing here, everywhere I had a k, I'm going to replace it with a k plus 1. Okay, so this actually is going to follow pretty closely to what we did in the previous example if you watched that video. So I'm going to start with the product. I'm going to start with what I want on the left. K plus 1, 1 minus 1 over I squared. Now I'm going to permute the product. I'm just going to pull, I don't know if that's the word for it, but that's what I'm doing. Basically, I'm going to pull out the K plus 1th term. And now it's really important that this k plus 1 term, that we recognize that this is a multiplication. This is no longer addition because this is a giant product, right? That product means multiplication, so you have to be sure and put in that multiplication sign. All right, so it's going to be everywhere I see a I, an I, I'm going to put a k plus 1. All right, now the next step is to remember that I had this assumption up here. So this assumption here matches up perfectly with what I have here. So I just need to put in that, whatever you call it, that substitution. So I've got that has to be equal to k plus 1 over 2k, and then times 1 minus 1 over k plus 1 squared. Now this is really important that you keep kind of going back to your goal and kind of thinking ahead of, like, algebraically, what do I need to do to get back to my goal? And This is going to take a little bit of work, but that's okay. So we're just going to start multiplying it out because nothing immediately screams out as obvious. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to multiply this by each one of these terms, just distribute that across. So I've got k plus 1 over 2k minus k plus 1 over 2k times k plus 1 squared. And now hopefully, without too much pain and agony, you can realize that those are going to cancel out. So if you just want to rewrite it kind of pretty, k plus 1 over 2k minus 1 over 2k times k plus 1. Now we're going to go ahead and make sure we have a 5, get ourselves a common denominator. So I'm going to multiply the top and the bottom here by k plus 1. And then I'll be able to combine them. So on the top, on the left side, I've got k squared plus 2k plus 1. Then I'm going to subtract off this 1. So this is this part right here. And then this here is this part. Okay, just so you got that. I don't need to keep all that on there. But, right? And then it's going to be over 2k times k plus 1. All right, now I just keep doing math. I've got k squared plus 2k, 2k k plus 1. Factor out the k. Oops. K plus 2. 2k k plus 1. Those k's go away. And I've got k plus 2 over 2 k plus 1, which seems like it's close. Let's go remember what I was trying to do in the first place. So in the first place, I was trying to show k plus 1 plus 1. And so that's really easy to write. And I'm just writing that special k plus 1 out separately just to show that I can match what I had as a goal exactly with no additional algebraic manipulation. So now that my goal matches what I got, I can go ahead and write, again, QED, which is actually means something else, but it just means end of proof. Like, therefore, it is demonstrated. But anyway, so that's, again, what you're doing is you're going to start by proving it for some kind of a base case. So you're going to show it here for some kind of base case. Then if you assume it's true for some k, then it also has to be true for all k plus 1 that follow. So that's kind of how you're going to do that.